this year I cannot be wasted. Say, my father, as I pray now, this 2021, I will never be wasted.
I will never be wasted.
Open your mouth and pray this prayer. I will not be wasted. I will never be wasted. Open your mouth and pray this prayer. I will not be wasted. My family will not be wasted. My children will not be wasted. My destiny will not be wasted. My marriage will not be wasted. Business will not be wasted.
Amen.
Fire.
Clap your hands and sit down. Hallelujah. That is our topic this morning. They can't waste me. They cannot waste you. It's not possible. Somebody shout, it's not possible. Are you there? Praise the Lord. A waster is a destroyer. For those of you writing, a waster is a terminator. Destroyers don't have pity over you. Wasters are terminators of destiny. They are enemies of light. They are enemies of breakthrough. They are enemies of your joy. Anybody that can plan to waste you does not like your destiny, does not like you. Wasters are destiny destroyers. Somebody shout fire. I pray for you. Anyone that want to waste your life when it is not God's time, may their own life be wasted.
Amen.
Yeah, seven fires shall conclude it. One.
Fire.
Two.
Fire.
Three.
Fire.
Four.
Fire.
Five.
Fire.
Six.
Fire.
Seven.
Fire.
Wasters are killers of tomorrow. If you have an uncle who is a waster, he's a killer of tomorrow. Are you there? Is a killer of tomorrow. Any waster around you this year, not even this year, this month, may Jehovah waste them one after the other.
Amen.
I'm not hearing your amen.
Amen.
Can I hear amen like a thunder?
Amen.
If there is any trace of failure or stagnation in any form, if you look into it very closely, you will discover that there's a waster there. If there's any trace of delay in your life or stagnation, hear me. If you look down deep into it, you will discover there's a waster standing. I prophesy to 21 of you.
I receive
it. Every man or woman, evil uncle, evil brothers, I don't care to know their name, family related, that are vowed to waste your children, waste your marriage, waste your destiny, waste your future, waste your finances. Today, I decree, before the end of this month, may heaven waste your lives.
Amen.
21 of you that will jump up and shout amen, may heaven waste your lives.
Amen.
A time comes in the life of a believer, you change your prayer point. Wasters are enemy of your future. Wasters are enemies of your next level. When you are about to cross to the next level, wasters must show up. Wasters are demons that monitor you. They are principalities and they are powers. They are witchcraft powers in the high places. They operate in a new level. They operate in a modern level. Wasters have gone digital. They operate with computer these days. Can I pray for somebody? Anyone that wants to waste your engagement, whenever a young man comes to engage a sister, before you know the waster will show up. When you are close to your miracle, before you know the waster will show up. Every near success syndrome stands, there's a waster. If there's any near success syndrome around you, there's a waster. If there's any delay around you, there's a waster who has vowed that this thing cannot get to you. Can I prophesy? Anyone that will wave his hands as I prophesy, may God wave away your waster. As you wave your hand prophetically, may Jehovah wave away every waster of your children. Every waster of your way, of your destiny. Say, Father, wave them off my life.
Father, wave them off my life.
Isaiah 54, verse 16 to 17. Isaiah 54. Are you there? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, blessed Holy Spirit. There's somebody in this service. Thank you, Jesus. You were poisoned in the dream. You are poisoned in the dream. When time comes, there's a level of prayer we're going to pray. You will vomit that poison here. Amen. I'm not hearing your amen. Amen. When time comes, there's a power that will hit you. That poison must come out of you in Jesus' name. Amen. He said, behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coal in the what? Fire. You know the smith, the goldsmith that mold golds. God said, I am the one that created them. They blow fire in their instrument of work. Because without fire, the gold will not be refined. Is that true? No, I'm not hearing you. Is that true?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And bringeth what? Forth an instrument for his work. Work. I am the God that created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire and bringeth forth an instrument for his work. I am that God that created the good and the bad. Now, I have created the waster also to do what? You can still be refined by God. You can still be refined. A gold can still be refined. But in the process of refining the gold, the waster, the enemy can still come to destroy the gold. Do you know that? That is how a lot of us, our destinies, our families, why God is processing you, why God has put you on the fire to refine you. The waster, God said, I have also created the waster to destroy. He said, I have presented before you good and bad, life and death. But he said, choose life that ye may live. Am I talking to somebody here? Hear me. Wasters are always there. When the smiths want to prepare the gold to be refined, there's always a waster. That is to say, when God is working on you, the waster will always appear. When heaven is preparing a table before you in the presence of your enemies, the wasters will come. That is why God will never prepare a table before you in the presence of your friends, in the presence of your loved ones. No, he will always prepare the table in the presence of your enemies. The Bible says the same God that prepared the smith, that molded the gold, that furnishes the gold, is the same God that created the waster. But it is in your hand to choose the one that you want. Lift up your hand and say, My Father, I reject wasters.
I reject wasters.
My life shall not be wasted.
My life shall not be wasted.
I will complete my years on earth.
I will complete my years.
I'm not hearing you say it. I will complete my years on earth.
I will complete my years on earth.
No power can waste me.
No power can waste me.
No demon can waste me. God said, I am also the one that created the waster to destroy. That's why the Bible said the power of life and death lies in your tongue. All this, my sickness. I keep telling you. You are making a big mistake. You are claiming ownership of that sickness, and that sickness will remain in your body. It's not your sickness. The Bible says your body is the temple of the Lord, and it's only the Holy Spirit that is permitted to live in you. Any other thing is a stranger. That's why he said in that book of Psalm, Psalm 18 verse 44, he said, as soon as the strangers hear my voice, they shall do what? They shall obey me. I don't understand. This guy met me yesterday that is, they said he's in protocol. Did you join the protocol now? Huh? You have joined the protocol. Okay, want to be standing when they are standing? You. Thank God. Is that why you're wearing uniform with them? Okay. That is one thing God said. When you fail in your duty, he will raise even stones. Come, let me anoint you. Huh? Get me oil. No oil. Stand here. Stand. From today, you'll be working as a protocol, eh? Good. Stand. Give me. When they fail in their duty, heaven will raise men. Father, I put oil in his life. Jesus, your name is Yahweh. You are the miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh. Hamagi moni romo. Hamagi mundi romo. Ihena magi agagi amamo. Hamagi moni romo. Ihena magi agagi amamo. Hamagi moni romo. I say, Hamagi moni romo. I say, I don't know my enemies. I don't know my enemies. What I don't know will never know me. I don't know my enemies. Oh, what I don't know will not know me. I don't know my enemies. Oh, somebody sit down. God bless you. I have created the western to destroy. It's in your hand to choose. Okay, go ahead. Let's see something. Verse 17. He said, but no weapon formed against me shall do what? Shall prosper. God said, I know you are weak sometimes to speak to yourself. But I stand as God to declare that no weapon formed against thee shall prosper. Can somebody shout amen? Amen. He said, every weapon and every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, then you shall do what? Listen, the Bible did not say he will condemn for you. It is in your hand to condemn. Are you hearing me? Stop waking up in the midnight and you're begging God. What are you begging God for? You have the right. He said, to them that believe, I give the power to become the sons of God. You discover what you don't like in your dreams. You wake up and condemn it. Somebody say condemn.
Condemn.